recently I went through and used a tool called Mint. It's on the website, mint.com. And if any of you are unfamiliar with Mint, it's a tool that goes through, you connect it, your bank account to the Mint tool, and it scans all of your expenses and looks at them over time and paints a picture, like a pie chart, bar charts, all kinds of things, and paints a picture for like what it is you're spending money on and how you're spending money. So I recently did that. I went through and connected my banking account to Mint, and sure enough, it spit out a picture and shows what I was spending money on. I don't want to say I was pissed. I want to say more so I was sad or just like bummed out over the fact that all that time I've spent earning the money that has just gone out the door will never come back again. That's not the fact that I've just spent it. I realize you have to spend money. It's just the fact that I did it without doing the proper due diligence that money deserves before just letting it fly out of your bank account. So once I had a picture of what it is I was spending money on, things like going out to eat, the types of lodging that I stay in when I travel, electricity, water, cell phone, all kinds of things. So I went through each thing that I was disgusted with, the amount of money I'm spending on going out to eat, all those things, and I figured out like ways. I've been looking at ways to figure out how to cut those costs, because like many of you, like you figure out a way to live comfortably. Maybe you're in debt, maybe you're not. And everything seems okay. Maybe you have a little bit of savings, maybe you don't. But you figure out a way to make things happen and you become comfortable with the way things are, like not questioning deeply at a deep level what it is you're spending money on, which is why I would encourage you to use a tool like Mint or something similar to it. But let's just dive into like some of the expenses that I'm referring to for myself and maybe you can relate. For years, I've used Verizon for my cell phone, both personal and business. And I just assumed Verizon had the best coverage and spending the money that I spent on it is justified. Well, I dug a little bit deeper and I found out that Sprint, which is a competitor of Verizon, is very similar. They have unlimited data and they have very good coverage. The only difference is their unlimited data is literally half the price, maybe a little less than what I pay for Verizon. So I'm planning to switch over to Sprint, and that money I'll save is literally mine to keep for free. Another example is going out to eat, right? Like I often get requests from friends and people to meet them out for dinner, and I will, right? I'll go grab dinner and drinks and all those things, appetizers, dessert, whatever. Well, recently I've made the switch. Like if I'm going to, instead of having dinner and drinks and appetizers and all that with people, I'll have dinner before I go and then go meet them for a couple drinks and maybe like a small appetizer or something like that. And just doing that one thing alone saves like 15, 20 bucks. I just put in my pocket and set to the side. Another thing is I recently sold one of my cars, right? It was a nice newer car, almost new. And the insurance that it was required was super expensive because it was worth a lot of money. The car was worth quite a bit of money. It was a little Subaru car that was very nice. I sold that car and now I drive a 28-year-old Land Cruiser, which is probably the best car I've ever owned. And the maintenance that it takes to keep a car that's 28 years old and has 260,000 miles on it is a fraction of the payments that it costs to own a car, and also the insurance that it takes to keep it on the road. Another example is I recently started shopping at a place called Aldi. It's a grocery store. I don't know if there's any in your area. I know they're pretty much nationwide, but for many years I've shopped at Whole Foods and places like Harris Teeter and all that, and I would just plop the money down. I just figured that's how it was. When I first walked into Aldi, I had another one of those like I'm pissed or like bummed out moments, because I was looking at organic food, which I'm a very healthy eater, and it was literally a third, maybe, and sometimes half, sometimes a third the price of organic food that you pay at Whole Foods or a company or a grocery store like Harris Teeter. The first time I went there, I was so excited. I purchased like basically an entire shopping cart of food, and it came out to be like 60 bucks, which lasted me for weeks. So why am I saying this? Why am I going through telling you all of these things that I've done recently? Is because the same is true for you. I'm sure most of you are spending money on things that you don't need to spend money on. A lot of times, instead of finding a way to save the money, the option is to just not make that purchase altogether. Just forfeit making that purchase and then realize later on that like you didn't even need it in the first place. An example of what I mean is this camera that I'm shooting on. It's a Sony A6300, right? And I was recently told about another camera that supposed to be one level up, but it was like $4,000, right? And I already own this camera. I bought it several years ago, and it has some outdated features, but it's fine. It's getting the job done. Tiny House Listings channel is growing very well, and I think I'm going to stick with this thing for a while until that camera, the price of that one, goes down a little bit, and then I'll take those few thousand dollars that I saved and put in my pocket towards something like retirement or whatever. And the sum total of doing these type of things, like slashing expenses or not even having those expenses altogether can add up to be huge. It can add up to be the difference between being able to retire, the difference between being able to take on a job that you'd prefer that pays less instead of having a job that you're miserable or sad at, or the difference between having enough money to pay cash for a tiny house, or most importantly, the difference between being in debt or not. So yeah, please consider going through and using a tool like Mint or something like that and seeing how it makes you feel when you look at those expenses that you've been participating in, and maybe it'll help you give you some ideas of like figure out ways to cut costs everywhere. So if you have examples of ways that you like to save money, please leave them in the comments below. Hope you like this video, and we'll see you on the next one.